Gone are the brutal massacres of the past, but the intent is the same. Destroy Christianity and create an Islamic state throughout Indonesia. 10 years have now passed since the worst of the jihad against Christians here in Indonesia, but today believers are still suffering, especially those who convert from Islam to Christianity and those who share their faith with others. Also, churches are being closed down. It's a shift in tactics for extremist groups such as the Islamic Defenders Front, FPI. They incite mob violence, force churches to close, and push for the arrest of church officials and evangelists. One of the worst attacks came against the Philadelphia Batak Christian Protestant Church of Bekasi last Christmas. A mob similar to this one gathered at the local mosque and then tried to prevent the Christians from meeting at their newly built church. Pastor Palti says the mob grew to about 1,500.
Some threw stones and were shouting, "Allahu Akbar, God is great." Others were calling us kafirs, infidels, and pigs and yelling obscenities. Some carried sticks and others shouted, "Burn the church, close it down."
Local officials closed the church last January. Since then, Christians have worshipped outside every Sunday in front of the church gate. Angry Muslims place cow manure, broken glass, and dead rats in the street the night before in hopes of deterring worship attendance. The Indonesian Constitution guarantees religious liberty, but Christians say they experience less freedom than the Muslim majority. Mosques are being built, but few new churches are allowed for a growing Christian population. Gary Lane, CBN News, Jakarta.